Why do we love it when superheroes go bad? Twisted characters from Boys are trying to answer that. And if you want to know how twisted the lives of the cast is, the OSSA team is here for you. Who has named his son after Indiana Jones? Who has earned the silliest scar over a stack of plastic coffee cups? Who has a Harvard diploma and who made millions at Merrill Lynch before becoming an actor? Hi, this is Clive. Let's take a look at it all. Anthony Starr as the Homelander. Does this man have a heart? You probably asked yourself while watching the series. The violent superhero with unexpected secrets is a great character to portray, says Anthony Starr. Although he was pretty skeptical that he would land a role like this, because Homelander is a big, muscular dude, and Anthony thought of himself as a simple, average man. Which he really is not. Starr actually did martial arts and karate for 8 years when he was growing up. Something that the average man definitely doesn't do. By the way, it seems he was quite an impulsive young man. There was one silly incident when Anthony was 15. He was working at a supermarket and accidentally knocked over a stack of plastic coffee cups. In anger, he threw one at a concrete wall, and it rebounded back and cut his head open. Anthony comments that it is probably the stupidest way to get a scar, but he really got one because of that. What else do we know about the star? Before his role on The Boys, Anthony was already quite the superstar. His character Lucas Hood was a great success during the fourth season run of the series Banshee. Anthony is super private with his personal life, and that's why his Instagram account is mostly filled with pics from Boys and the cutest pictures with his dog. Anyway, the web states that Anthony does have a partner, a mysterious Lucy McClay. If you dig a little, there are a couple of Lucy McClays out there, but there's only one on the IMDb listed as a costume designer, who worked on the very same project as Anthony Starr, which is a popular New Zealand TV show, Outrageous Fortune. However, the only public picture you can find of the two was made back in 2008, which of course makes the whole assumption a very weak one. Anyhow, the press continues to state that the two are still together. The only time he opened up about his affairs was at an interview with NZ Herald, where he admitted that his girlfriend could not watch his fight scenes in Banshee's brutal battles. Was that Lucy and are they still together is quite a mystery. Dominique McGilligott as Queen Maeve. Queen Maeve started her way in Seven the same as Starlight with an open heart and high hopes, and now she just wants to get out of it. In real life, Dominique McGilligott is not naive at all. The Irish actress started her acting career at 15. With hard work on the set, she did not even have time for blurry thoughts. Throughout her career, she mainly acted in independent movies that are not much known, although there is one project in her CV you're most probably familiar with. McGilligott played Hannah Conway, wife of the Republican presidential nominee in The House of Cards. Just like Anthony, Dominique is very protective of her personal life. She does not have any social media profiles and avoids publicity as much as she can. McGilligott explains her position. As an actor, I don't want people to know too much about me so that they see me as the person in whatever role I'm in. I'm not against it, but I prefer being old school. This old school lady dreams to have some time off so that she can get back to her cozy home and just be lazy, getting pleasure from reading books and yoga. Erin Moriarty as the Starlight. Erin Moriarty is way more public personality than her colleagues. She loves to share posts with her fans on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And she also encourages Eric Kripke, the creator of the show, to start his own account. But seems the writer of The Boys and another famous series, Supernatural, stubbornly stays out of it. Moriarty is famous to Disney fans as she played Hope Schlottman in the Marvel and Netflix series Jessica Jones. Although for others, she is best known for appearing in series such as True Detective and One Life to Live. Talking about her dating life, I can say one thing for sure. Erin manages to hide her relationships way better than her character in Boys. Chace Crawford as the Deep. I bet most of the Gossip Girl fans are more than pleased to see Chace Crawford once again, although I'm pretty sure they hoped for, a rather more pleasant character for the actor. Well, at least he has some ambition about saving dolphins. As fans may know, Crawford dated actress Rebecca Rittenhouse, whom he met on the set of Blood and Oil 4 years ago. But this spring, the actor recently implied that he was back on the market. What's more, Chase even gave some hints on how to make a move on him. Listen, some Knicks tickets, a pizza, he told Us Weekly with a laugh. That's it, said Chase. So if you are dying to get a chance with a guy, you now know exactly what to do. Tomer Capon as Frenchie. That simultaneously soft yet macho French guy is actually portrayed by Israeli actor Tomer Capon. And nope, he doesn't speak French, so what you hear is basically more of his Hebrew accent. Capon was probably the only one from the cast who was previously familiar with the comic book and loved it, so he really wanted to be a part of the TV show. Before becoming an actor in his late 20s, Capon was a paratrooper in the army. He even commanded a group of soldiers and took service during the 2006 Lebanon War. Perhaps this tough experience helped Capon make Frenchie look so skilled when it comes to the martial arts. In real life, Capon has a pretty stable and happy relationship with Israeli actress Ortal Ben-Shushan. You can spot the two playing a couple on the Israeli TV show Full Moon. Although, seems that that's the most we will find out about the couple, as both do not speak too openly about their real-life relationship. "We're simple people, and privacy is important to us," Capon told Mako in 2018. But the actor did give one special tip for dealing with relationship tensions, though. "We have a trampoline, and we jump on it together," said Capon. You can try it yourself next time you're having an argument with your beloved. Karen Fukuhara as Kimiko. And what about Capon's on-screen love interest, Kimiko? Well, it's not Karen Fukuhara's first time playing someone with superpowers, as she played Swordmaster Katana in the DC film Suicide Squad. Let's just say it, Karen is a real martial artist and has a brown belt. And that side of the actress naturally combines with Karen's sweet character. Seems the actress is fully in her work right now, as there is not the slightest hint of her dating life. Or, as her many on-set friends, she is really good at keeping her private life out of the public eye. Elisabeth Shue as Madelyn Stillwell. Award-winning actress Elisabeth Shue is the woman behind the nasty character, and she is full of surprises. Her debut was in The Karate Kid, when she played the sweetheart of the main character. And you might remember her part in the Back to the Future films. You would think that Elisabeth Shue was always an actress due to her countless roles. However, Shue could have chosen a totally different path, as she was a very serious Harvard student. Although, her passion for acting made her leave studies. But after 15 years, she did come back to her alma mater and completed her BA in political science. What a great will! Today, Elisabeth seems to have a wonderful time in both her professional and intimate life. Shue has been married to producer and director Davis Guggenheim for over 25 years, and the two have raised three wonderful children, Miles, Stella, and Agnes. Laz Alonso as Mother's Milk. The most surprising thing about the actor is that before his movie career, the man was a successful investment banker at Merrill Lynch on Wall Street. But his passion to act was always with him, and so he enrolled in evening acting classes while being a serious businessman during the day. At the beginning of the new millennium, Laz Alonso let himself be fully driven by his passion, and now we know him as a real TV veteran. Aside from his countless TV roles, he also got pretty big roles on big screen. He played the main antagonist in the fourth film of Fast and Furious, and had a major role as a Navi warrior in James Cameron's iconic Avatar. Alonso is not any less successful in his personal life, as last year he confirmed his relationship with the reality show star Chandra Delicious Davis. It is not clear whether the two have serious intentions, but it seems that Alonso is damn romantic with his bae, as the star posted this on her Instagram, thanking Alonso for his generous gesture. Well, I hope they will keep their romance for long. Karl Urban as Billy Butcher. Eric Kripke had no other person in mind to play the Hughie's guide into the darker nature of superheroes than Karl Urban, probably because Karl is no stranger to the grittier, action-packed roles. The actor's first famous role was in the horror film Ghost Ship, and ever since, Urban played in lots of great movies, including the second and third parts of the Lord of the Rings trilogy. Urban portrayed Eomer in the Tolkien universe. And of course, most fans remember Urban as Leonard McCoy in the Star Trek reboot film series. Let's now check what is going on in the off-screen life of the actor. Long time ago, Urban tied the knot with his makeup artist, Natalie, who worked with him in the television movie The Privateers. The couple have two sons together, Hunter and Indiana. By the way, their second son is named after Indiana Jones, as this is one of the Urban's favorite characters. After 10 years of marriage, Karl and Natalie decided they both needed change, so the two parted ways. The next year, the actors seemed to fall in love again, this time with American actress Katie Sackhoff. Their love seemed to have grown stronger as time passed by, as after a couple of months, Karl introduced Katie to his family, friends, and children. Despite constant rumors of their breakup, the couple is still going pretty strong together. Jack Quaid as Hughie. Seems Jack was famous from birth, as publicity is a common thing in his family. That is because he is the son of two well-known Hollywood actors, Meg Ryan and Dennis Quaid. Despite that, Jack is a relatively new face in Hollywood. The actor revealed that he mainly refused any introductions his mom or dad offered him and wanted to make it on his own. For Jack, it was a principle thing. "I love this so much that I do want it to be mine," explained Jack to Los Angeles Times. So, his debut role happened only in 2012 when Jack played the contestant Marvel in The Hunger Games. Funny thing about that, Jack revealed that the fans of the movie still gets angry comments about his character, as he killed a cute little girl, Rue. Aside from that, Jack received a couple of not very significant roles, and now it seems his time for stardom has finally come. Today, Jack is well known as the leading character of the boys' gang. Together with glory came much more publicity, but seems the actor has no problems with that. Jack is willingly sharing his personal life with his fans on his Instagram account. Just recently, he posted the sweetest post that celebrated 3 years of his relationship with actress Lizzie McGroder. Who knows, maybe we will soon get to see an Instagram post with news of an engagement. Which is quite possible. What else would you like to know about the Boys TV series? Share with us in the comments below, and we would be glad to meet your requests in the following awesome videos. And as always, thanks for staying awesome!